This is my mom, Laurie Kraus. For nearly 20 years, she worked three jobs at once. She was a paramedic, a unit coordinator at Bethesda North Hospital, and a paramedic trainer. Despite all her hard work, she was still able to set time aside for me. She is the mother that most kids my age envied, for she was involved in my school life. She is loving, passionate, and full of life. Things changed in March of 2010 when she became ill from renal failure. To save her life, she turned to a treatment called dialysis.
Dialysis is a process or a treatment to kidney disease. It filters the toxins and extra fluid from your bloodstream. There are two types of dialysis. One is peritoneal dialysis, and the other is hemodialysis.
The type of dialysis that I am on is called peritoneal dialysis, also known as PD, and it uses the peritoneal cavity in the abdomen as a kidney.
Every day, my mom must use a dialysis machine in order to survive. As she turns on the machine, it runs through a self-testing program. She then cuts open two dialysis bags and wipes them down. She sets a small bag next to the machine and a big one on top of it. She inserts a tubing cassette, which she later uses to hook up to her body. The machine tests the cassette to make sure it works. It is ready when the words "load the set" appears. She presses the go button and waits for the words "connect bags." She flings the tubes out from the cassette and takes it to the bathroom to drain. She returns to the machine where she removes the caps from the two bags and connects them, breaking the frangibles in both bags. The dialysis machine is then ready to be primed. This takes about 5 to 7 minutes. The words "connect yourself" appear, and she hooks up to the machine. She has to remain sterile in this step, otherwise she can risk infection. She then goes through a well in which the fluids from the bags go in and out of her body. This whole process of connecting to the machine takes up to a total of 14 hours. Once the machine has finished, she has to manually drain the remaining fluid inside of her.
Other things that, as a dialysis patient, there's a whole lot of medications. I mean, a boatload of meds. Some are for sugar, some are for phosphorus, some are for special vitamins, some are for blood pressure. There's, you know, at least two blood pressure meds there. I have to take aspirin because of the TIA I had. I take aspirin every day. There's just so many meds that you have to take. It's such a fine balancing act. Another thing that I have to do is keep track of all of my numbers from my dialysis. I have a dialysis log. I mean, you just have to keep track of so many things, and you have to really be due diligent keeping track of that, doing it like you're supposed to on a daily basis.
My daily routine is affected or changed to now include preparing, helping her prepare for the process, having the supplies ready for her, inhaling the inventory. I set the individual boxes or sets that are used on a daily basis. I assemble those to her for her. I do that typically once a week, so that there's about six, seven days worth of supplies available at the beginning of each week, and then we consume them, or she consumes them, I don't. And then also helping her with her transportation to and from medical visits, either to the clinic or to the doctors, and that's what has changed.
The life expectancy of someone on dialysis, especially PD dialysis, can range. It's a very wide range, just depends on your other health issues, whether you have a heart condition, diabetes. All those other issues have to be monitored as well, and that decides how long you live on dialysis, not necessarily dialysis alone.
Laurie's experience is with dialysis have changed our lives, the entire families. It's affected me and is a loved one who cares for her and sees her going through the issues that she has. It's become, as Laurie often says, her new normal. So it has become a new normal just for her, not only for her, but for all of us as well. 33 years ago, you said vows to one another or to each other, and this is part of it. In some ways, it's made our relationship even stronger because we know that we are here to appreciate, we rely on one another, and that we're in it for the duration.
The renal failure has taken so much away from my mom. She can't hold a job. Her energy levels are often depleted, and her spirits are usually low. Much of the lively woman that I knew as a kid is gone. I have had many fond memories of her, and there still can be more. The dialysis has given her a chance to live longer, 3 years and counting. This is her new normal. She takes one day at a time. Some are bad, others are good. I am thankful and gracious that she is still with our family.